Are your electrical installations truly safe? Today we're breaking down fault loop impedance calculations from AS/NZS 3000, Appendix B5.2.2. Learn how to find the maximum cable route length and see how different circuit breakers impact safety. Let's start. One method of verifying the requirements of fault loop impedance is to use the calculation outlined in AS/NZS 3000, Appendix B5.2.2. This calculation will give maximum cable route lengths in meters for selected conductor sizes, conductor material, and circuit breaker instantaneous tripping current. When an installation's external impedance is unknown, it can be assumed that at least 80% of the phase voltage will be available at the protection device during a fault situation. In most cases, the external circuit's impedance will be low enough to allow for higher voltage values at the protection device. However, using the 80% voltage value will ensure calculated maximum lengths are always safe. This percentage gives a voltage value of 184 volts for working the equation. The Greek letter rho represents material resistivity at working temperatures, given in ohms per millimeter squared per meter, with values for copper and aluminium given. IA represents protection device's current value for instantaneous tripping. For example, a 10 amp C-type circuit breaker requires 7.5 times its rated value for instantaneous tripping. The final consideration is the cross-sectional area in millimeter square of the phase and protective earth conductors. Let's put some numbers into our equation and see what answer we get. The selected cable will have 2.5 millimeter square copper phase and protective earthing conductors. The resistivity of copper conductors is represented by rho in the equation. Copper resistance per millimeter squared per meter gives a calculation value of 0.0225 ohms. The selected protective device is a 16 amp C-type circuit breaker with an instantaneous tripping current value of 120 amps. With all values entered, the calculation can now be made. The maximum length calculation gives an answer of 85 meters. A circuit length greater than this may result in fault loop impedance not being satisfied. Swapping a C-type breaker for a D-type breaker of the same rated current results in a maximum length of 53.24 meters. The D-type breaker requires a higher fault current for instantaneous operation. Substituting a B-type breaker in the circuit will significantly increase the maximum circuit length due to the lower value of fault current required for instantaneous operation of the device. When considering cables of 4 millimeters square and above, earthing conductors will have a smaller cross-sectional area than the active conductor. As an example of this, a 10 millimeter square cable will have a 4 millimeter squared earth wire. Next, watch this video to learn how to complete a verification of an electrical installation.